I want to actually use it online and see how it works, or if it works. If it doesn't work, that would be awesome as well, because like it would just be really cool to kind of go through how easy it is, what kind of, the machine might be doing KYC. So what a lot of people do sometimes when there is, you know, when there isn't clarity on what they're supposed to do, is that they try to just do like, you know, 20x. So they will collect information and...
Right. And the KYC thing is the thing that I hate. Like, I don't want there to be KYC. I want the machine and the people that are servicing the machine and the people that built the machine. I want those people regulated, not the people buying from the machine.
Dude, you have been yelling about KYC for years. Like, I swear to God, I remember you yelling about KYC last year, the year before that, KYC. But I mean, how else do you actually regulate an industry like that? Do you have a better solution?
But that's the thing, right? You don't need to regulate the ATM industry by regulating the users. I don't want to regulate the users. I want to regulate the solicitors of those users.
Good. Okay. You want to have them be responsible. Okay. So perhaps through some sort of insurance, you must have insurance to run something like that. Because
I don't even care about insurance. Like,
Tony, you are talking about insurance because you're actually talking about recourse. I think your concerns for KYC and all of this stuff and you know, just regulation, right, actually stems from recourse. That's what you're concerned about, is people who are like...
No, not recourse. I want preemptive regulation on the industry providing the service, not the users of that service. It would be great whether there's a government or like a private company that's responsible for making sure these ATM machines are legit. And if they're going to sell, and if they're going to sell you Bitcoin, they're selling you Bitcoin and not Bcash. But I don't want KYC on the users. I mean, KYC on the users is not regulating the industry. It's basically, it's horrible. I want the users to fall under some kind of privacy protection.
It's satisfying the regulators. But you're
saying in the opposite way, okay, like that it should.
Tone, if I may make a suggestion, is I'm guessing a lot of people who are watching this would agree with that perspective. And we're in a very interesting time in the development of this entire industry where the regulators, depending on whether it's in St. Kitts or in the United States or at the federal government level, they are just starting to think about these issues. And there's an opportunity for us as a community to actually influence how the regulations are being crafted and how they're being interpreted. So I would encourage, people to reach out and donate to like Coin Center or to reach out to local and state and federal and country, you know, depending on what country who your representatives are, and advocate on behalf of the industry from a position that's, generally beneficial to your locality, to whether it's a state or government. There's an argument that you can be made that we are more free as a society by not requiring every transaction that goes through a Bitcoin ATM to go through KYC. But just saying that it isn't fair is not going to accomplish anything. But there's an academic way of approaching this that I think the industry desperately needs right now. And you know, the people who are watching this now can start that. But there's arguments to be made, but unfortunately they're applying KYC requirements. At the state levels, they're requiring KYC requirements, unless they're not. You know, some states on the money transmission side are requiring quite a lot of information being taken in. Some are requiring almost nothing when it goes to crypto. We have an opportunity to influence this now. And depending on where you are, I would say get involved, because so few people know about this industry at this point and are talking to the people who are ultimately regulating them.
Guys, I have to leave. I have a call at 5:30. So.
All right. Thank you, Adela. Just mention our audience where they can find you and where you're located, like business-wise.
Please don't find me, but
okay.
If you want to follow me on Twitter, which I'm not a huge Twitter person, you can follow me at Bitcoin Khaleesi. Send me a message on Telegram.
All right, cool. Yeah. All right.
Bye, Adela.
Thanks, Adela.
Thank you so much.
Thanks. All right, Sasha, let's get your thoughts on the Bitcoin ATM, and then we're going to wind this down. We can definitely talk about this all day, and we'll definitely do one more of these next week.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I personally am on the side where I would love to see it where we didn't have to put in the KYC information to use the machine, but from the government's perspective, I don't think we're ever going to get there, because how would they tax on that if we didn't have, it would just create a whole, you know, network of ways for people to avoid their taxes. So I don't think we're ever going to get to a point, no matter what kind of thoughtful academic information we submit to them saying we shouldn't require KYC. I just think that they're always going to want that. So I think in order for the whole Bitcoin movement to keep going forward, we have to come up with more and more creative ways to maintain privacy beyond Bitcoin ATMs, because I don't think those are going to be a way for securely moving it without facing risk of regulation.
All right, final thoughts, Justin?
Yeah, I think each state and the federal government are still trying to figure out how to interpret it. I don't think it's out of the realm of possibility that eventually regulation will just put different tranches of KYC regulation depending on how much you're actually transacting. And maybe, you know, up until a certain point, you're just, you know, like Tone said, pre-registering from the service provider. But, you know, the Bitcoin ATM is going through some licensing requirement. They're putting up some bond and they're checking to make sure that person X is not transmitting more than whatever $1,000 to the ATM. Mm-hmm. Then once you hit a threshold, then you need to, you know, at the customer level, provide information. That might be a solution. It might not make everyone happy, but it's maybe a starting place, because it's certainly better than the alternative, which is every time you need to, you know, transact or exchange in Bitcoin, in some cases, you need to give quite a lot of information, which is a bit repressive.
Yeah, I think I work as I'm listed as a compliance person for a Bitcoin ATM company. So I've just recently went through all the fun stuff with getting that money service business application. I think what you just described would be the best way to do it. If you can make an account offline, put in your information the same way that you would with an exchange or Coinbase, and then use that ATM, that would satisfy every regulator, but there, I don't see a way to do it anonymously in America anyway.
To give the sort of Antonopoulos answer, though, the best way to avoid this is just only transact in Bitcoin and don't go in and out of fiat.
Exactly.
You know, find your own Bitcoin and use it if you can.
Yeah, that's my recommendation as well. But hey, not everybody accepts Bitcoin yet.
Not yet.
All right, guys, let's wrap up the show. Let's go ahead and say our goodbye. So, Justin, so tell our people where they can find you on Twitter and closing statements.
Yeah, so you can find me at Winston Ono Wales, and I think it's probably linked somewhere with you. And if you'd like to find my law firm profile, you can go to justinwales.com and it'll link you there, or carltonfield.com/blockchain, I think. We'll also link. And I think, Tone, I sent you, I think in a private message, the article that has all the state regulations. So if you need a quick primer on what's happening in your state, you can look at that. And it's updated every 3 months.
It's live updating.
He put it on the chat too here.
I'll do a quick screen share just for people in case they want to, you know, Google for it themselves. Yeah. But I will add this into the video description after we end the show.